given these are given different names. The absolute consciousness or Narayana consciousness is called I. Whenever you speak of I, you are speaking with reference to an unchanging consciousness, which is always pointing to absolute. So then when you say I am, it will represent to manifest consciousness, universal consciousness, which is Brahman. Okay? I am the body, you reference to Jiva. I am the body. Parabrahma, Brahma and Jiva. So you are very, very close. You are just turning your attention to there, Parabrahma is there. Turn your attention, Jiva is there. So they are all very, very close to you than you think, than you imagine. You are that consciousness. Again and again, go back to the divine consciousness. You will be free from suffering and you realize yourself as birthless, deathless, living being. Then you can say, Aham Brahmasmi, I am Brahman. Then also you can say, Sarvam Kharita Brahma, all this is Brahman. So you can confidently say, once you understand the meaning of Vedanta Purusha, Vedanta Vakya. So no, I have to meditate and realize, no. You have to get a clarity of Vedanta Vakya, then you realize. Then meditation becomes very simple. Meditation doesn't give you enlightenment. Enlightenment gives you meditation. Formless is consciousness, form is the world. Form and formless are not different, they are one and the same. The formless is called Brahman, which is represented by I. The form is called the world, which is called Sarvam. So both are same. A realish, complete realization involves Aham Brahmasmi and Sarvam Kharida Brahma. And when you realize this, you become Purna. You realize that I am Purna, I am fullness, I have no deficiency, I am the totality. That realization comes to picture. When that realization comes to picture, you are free from all kinds of suffering. That doesn't mean that there is a pain in the leg, there is a pain in the hand. They will be there, but it's not for you. For you, there is no pain because you are the consciousness. The pain appears in you, but doesn't mean that you will suffer from pain. So realize the Purna Madam, Purna Vidam, Purna Purna Vidachate, Purnasya Purna Madaya, Purna Mevavashishate. This realization is called form and formless. With this, I will close, then we will take question answer. Asatoma,
Asatoma,
Sadgamaya,
Sadgamaya,
Tamasoma,
Tamasoma,
Jyotirgamaya,
Jyotirgamaya,
Pratyoma,
Pratyoma,
Amritamgamaya,
Amritamgamaya,
Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti,
Om Shanti, Shanti.
Body. Now, when you take your attention to the body, consciousness is told, but consciousness is no part. the consciousness is not part, then no Purna. It's not Purna. The consciousness has no parts possible. No, Veshti consciousness is the appearance in Samashti. Appearance is not separate. For example, wave appears from in ocean. Wave we can call as Veshti. Ocean is Samashti. Now, tell me where is the boundary between the wave and ocean? But wave is an answer. The boundary is a mental concept of the wave. So, for the wave, you put a low level, you are part of Veshti, Samashti. But wave looks at Samashti, oh, I am part of that. Then you realize that there is no part actually. The Samashti cannot be part, it's continuous. If Samashti is a part, then Samashti is not Samashti.
Mental.
That is called in Vedanta, it's called superimposition. Okay. Mind superimposition. Okay, tell me. Where is Pakistan and where is India? If you look at it from space, you don't know where is Pakistan, where is India. Then you put a map. Map is made by a bit of human. This is Pakistan, this is mind, human. India. Then you put a gun in there and shoot Pakistan, so Pakistan shoot you. So it's all created by mind. In the creation, it's same. Next question.
What means mind keeps on shifting from form to form?
Correct.
Form to shift?
Correct.
Body conscious? Self.
Correct.
That is sorrow,
sorrow.
Right. No time. Mind doesn't self.
No time, so wait on?
Both. Sorrow and peace.
It cannot. Mind can be only one.
With lack of practice.
No, this is not lack of practice. This again, the practice doesn't make you perfect. The practice makes you perfect itself. Here, nana makes you perfect. Why mind is going after something? Because mind thinks it's real. Mind goes after a thought. The thought is real. It is not real. It is unreal. This is meant by Brahma Satya Jagan Mithya. Brahma Satya Jagan Mithya part is not understood, mind is running after the event. So Jagan Mithya is clear to you, Jagan Mithya is crystal clear to you, mind doesn't run. Now Jagan Mithya doesn't crystal clear to you because it doesn't become clear to you by meditation. Jagan Mithya becomes clear to you by Vedanta teaching, understanding Vedanta teaching.
He both sorrow and peace exist within.
No. There's no, the sorrow and peace are mental modification, right? The peace is the absence of sorrow. Sorrow and peace cannot exist together. But where is your attention? Is it on sorrow or peace? Sorrow is real or peace is real?
Peace is real, but unfortunately we are in sorrow.
That's because your attention is going to sorrow. Now why attention is going to sorrow? Because you think sorrow is real. You think world is real. What you have not recognized is, you have heard a lot of Vedantic teachings, but your recognition, understanding that Brahma Satya, Jagat Mithya has to be very crystal clear. Then the mind doesn't run, mind goes to consciousness. This is what is meant by Ravana Maharshi says, mind of who am I? You are not the body, you are not the mind, you are not the intellect, you are not the world is just appearance. It's like a mirage. So why are you going to drink water in the mirage? Because you don't know it's mirage. So the mind is going, I am trying out because it is not convinced Brahma Satya Jagat Mithya. Are you convinced Brahma Satya Jagat Mithya? Really? No. That's why the question. Brahma Satya Jagat Mithya. One part is the equation is not complete. Though both part of the equation should be complete. Any questions?
You said you
want
for conscious.
Huh?
What reflects the
energy? Who uses it? Vedanta doesn't use unconscious, no? That's insentient. Jada. So I am able to see the stone, I am aware of the stone, but stone is not aware of me. That's called insentient. Awareness.
But that also appears in the word expression of consciousness.
That's expression of consciousness, but the mind is rudimentary there. Because mind is rudimentary there, it is not able to recognize you. Mind is there, but it's very rudimentary. That's why insentient. Any more questions?